It was a nice journey to explain you all the important things for the NEET physics. I am really very happy that I am contributing something to help you all. Let me continue our journey with our 16th topic, that is surface tension. So let me just tell you the meaning of surface tension first. Surface tension is nothing but, the name itself is saying, tension. So the nature of the surface, like, it behaves like it is under some tension. You take a hand and dip it in the soap solution and slowly stretch the fingers. You will observe the soap solution or soap film between the fingers, and that slowly comes down like this. It tries to decrease its surface area. So it is behaving like someone is forcing it to decrease its surface area. So that kind of nature, what we call it as surface tension. And what might be the reason behind that one, if we think about it, there is the one reason that due to cohesive forces, that means when you consider the top surface of the liquid, this is the supposed top surface. Let me consider here. So here, this is the liquid surface and this is inside the liquid. Here if you consider one molecule within the volume, that is effective volume we call it as, within this whatever molecules are there, they can affect this one, means they will apply some interaction force. That interaction force, what we call it as, is the force of cohesion, because they are similar kind of molecules. So the forces of interaction between similar kind of molecules we call it as cohesive forces. But the molecule which is completely inside will get the forces in all the directions equally, so that the resultant force is zero. That will be in equilibrium. But if you consider the one molecule on the top surface, then it gets force only within the liquid, because there is air outside. Now the resultant of all these forces is downward. So that every molecule on the surface gets a resultant force downward, so that due to these cohesive forces, the liquid surface tries to decrease its surface area. So that kind of nature only what we are calling it as surface tension. And that surface tension, we can define that the force per unit length at the contact. So if you imagine an imaginary line on the surface, so the force per unit length, or due to surface tension, what is the force acts along that line, is surface tension times length. But here if you consider one arrangement like U-shaped frame with a sliding wire and dip it inside the soap solution and remove it, here you will get the soap film. Now if you observe it, if you keep it horizontal, this slowly moves leftward. You will observe that it will move leftward. So you can conclude that there is some resultant force leftward, but you are not pushing it or pulling it. So here the one who is pulling it is the force due to surface tension, and that force per unit length is called surface tension. And here I am taking 2L, because here the soap film means there are two surfaces, one is this side, one is back side, so that one length is this side, the other length is back side, so the total effective length is 2L. So based on this, first question can come, that is, what is the force due to surface tension? If you take frame, like one square frame on the liquid surface, so there is one length inside and one length outside. So for one side you will get 2L. So the total four sides means 4 into 2L, 8L. So what is the force will become then? T into 8L. surface tension times total length in contact. But if you take a plate, like suppose circular plate, only outside the contact is there. So what is the total length? 2 pi r times surface tension. But if it is a frame, circular frame, then 2 pi r plus 2 pi r. Or if it is suppose annular limb, like inner radius r1, outer radius r2, then 2 pi r1 plus 2 pi r2 times surface tension. Here 2 pi small r1, here 2 pi small r2. So times surface tension. So based on this, the first kind of question can come, that is the equation of force due to surface tension, first thing. Next, if you consider surface energy. Now consider the same case like the frame case. Now you apply some force and you increase the surface area. Let's take you have moved by a distance x. This is the length of the wire. Then what is the area changed? L into x. But as I told, there are two surfaces. The total increase in area is 2 times Lx. One is this side, one is other side. Then what is the work done due to this force? Force times displacement, F into x. Then you multiply with 2L, divide with 2L. Force per unit length is surface tension, x into 2L. That is nothing but what? Change in area. So surface tension into change in area is what? The work done. What is this work done? Work required to change the surface area. That means configuration of liquid changed. So the work done required to change the configuration, what happens? It will store as potential energy. But here this is the potential energy of a liquid surface. That's why we call it as surface energy. So based on this, next type of question can come. So what is that type of question? Let us take some example. So find work done in blowing or formation of a liquid drop or bubble. Either drop or bubble, anything they can ask you. Suppose first you consider drop. Drop and bubble, if you consider, the difference is drop means only outside area. Bubble means there are two cases, bubble in air, bubble in liquid. So bubble in air means there are two surfaces, inside and outside. So bubble in liquid means only inside, 4 pi r square. That is the difference. So bubble in liquid or drop, both are same. But bubble in air case means what? There are two surfaces, depending upon the question you have to take. So you are forming a drop means you are changing the area from 0 to 4 pi r square. If you are blowing the drop means you are changing the area from 4 pi r square to 0. But in both the cases, what is the change in area? Magnitude 4 pi r square. So that here the work done is surface tension times 4 pi r square, which is also same as in case of bubble in liquid. But in case of bubble in air will become 2 times of this one, because there are two surfaces. So in case of formation or in case of blowing off, the work done is surface tension times change in surface area. So this way you try to remember it. Now they can give the numerical values, you can substitute based on this one. But sometimes they will give the question little bit tricky or logical or tough. That is based on find work done in merging or dividing. Like one drop is there, one big drop of radius capital R. Now it divided into n small drops each of radius R. As we discussed in the case of viscosity, then the volume remains constant, so R cube equal to nR cube. From this you can get the relation between small r and capital R. Then after finding, then you find delta A. Suppose in case of dividing, the final area is 4 pi r square times n. One drop is 4 pi r square, n drops is n into 4 pi r square minus. Then 4 pi capital R square. Suppose for example you consider n is 64. Then what you can write? R cube equal to 4 cube R cube. So R equal to 4R. Now substitute here delta A. 4 pi R square. So here take care one thing that if they mention only small r, write the equation in terms of small r. If they give only capital R, then write in terms of capital R. Suppose they have given capital R only, then 4 pi small r plus what I can write r by 4 whole square times n minus 4 pi r square. If you take 4 pi r square common, n by 16 minus 1. Now n is how much? 64. So 4 pi r square, 64 means 16, 4 is 4 minus 1, 3, 12 pi r square. Now change in area, what happened? Positive. Then delta u t delta a is also positive. So surface energy got increased. That means it absorbed energy. So here it absorbed energy r, it taken some energy to divide into drops. Suppose it combined, suppose small drops combined to form one big drop, then energy releases, then delta A becomes what? Negative. So delta A negative means energy releases, delta A positive means energy absorbed. So based on this also questions can be asked. So try to understand and practice. First thing is volume remains constant, so you can take this relation to get the relation between the big radius and small radius. Then you go for the change in area, then you can calculate the work done or change in surface energy. This is the type of questions you can get based on surface energy. After that, one more thing, excess pressure. If you take a bubble, so you will play with the bubble shooter. If you blow the bubbles, they will blow off after some time because of excess pressure inside them. So the excess pressure means pressure inside minus pressure outside. Outside means atmospheric pressure is called excess pressure, and that is equal to 2T by R in case of drop and 4T by R in case of bubble, because as I told, two surfaces. So based on this also questions will come. Suppose one question you take here, the question given is like, what is the question given? Find ratio of volumes of bubbles whose pressure inside is 1.02 atmosphere and 1.04 atmosphere. So they are not given excess pressure, they have given inside pressure. There are two bubbles. Now one pressure inside you consider P1, another one you consider P2. Now P1 minus P0 is 2T by R1. P2 minus P0 is 2T by R2. Now here the P1 is 1.02 minus P0 is atmospheric pressure, 1 atmosphere, equal to 2T by R1. Similarly 1.04 minus 1 equal to 2T by R2. Then if you take the ratio, here it is 0.02, here it is 0.04 equal to R2 by R1. This by this I have taken. So that R1 by R2 will become 4 by 2, that is 2. But they are not asking the ratio of radius, they are asking the ratio of volume. Volume is proportional to what? R cube. So V1 by V2 is R1 by R2 whole cube, that is 2 cube. How much you will get? 8. So this is the way you can solve the question, some questions related to what? Excess pressure. So last time final one, that is related to capillary action. That is, if you take a capillary tube and dip inside the liquid, then depending upon the angle of contact, what is angle of contact? In a simple way, take this is the solid surface on which if there is a liquid drop or liquid is in contact, then at the contact you draw one line and at the same point you draw tangent to liquid surface, and that angle is theta, angle of contact, like for this one, this is the angle of contact. Here theta greater than 90, here theta less than 90. So here cos theta negative, here cos theta positive. So here what happens is the liquid drops, that means like this. If this is the liquid and you dip one capillary tube, so if the angle is greater than 90, that means the shape is, the shape of the liquid here is convex like this. So the tangent and the solid inside the liquid having the angle greater than 90. If it is concave, so this is tangent, this is solid in liquid, then the angle is less than 90, then the liquid rises because cos theta positive. And if you derive the formula also, it will come h equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g, where r is the radius of the tube, theta is the angle of contact. So cos theta negative, for theta greater than 90, so h is negative, so there is a drop in the height. Similarly, for theta less than 90, there is a rise in the height. This kind of action is called capillary rise. But our main thing is how to solve the questions based on this. Let us take one question here. So, what is the question? If m is the mass of water in capillary tube having radius r, then find mass of water raised in capillary tube of radius 2r in the same liquid. Now here there is a liquid and there is a capillary tube of radius r. Then what is h will become 2t cos theta by r rho g. T is same for both the tubes. Theta is same because same nature. Rho is same, g is same, only r is different. And here h is inversely proportional to r. Yes sir. Then h2 by h1 equal to r1 by r2, r by, and the new radius is r, so 1 by 2. So h2 is h1 by 2 or else h by 2. Now initially for the first tube, if you consider mass, what kind of shape it is? Cylindrical shape. Suppose up to some height h the liquid rises. Then what is the volume of the cylinder? Pi r square h. Volume into density. This is the mass. Now if you consider in the second case m dash, then what is the volume? Pi. Radius is 2r whole square. Height is h by 2 times 2. Then 2 square is 4. 4 by 2 is how much? 2. So it will become 2 times pi r square h rho. That means 2m. So as the radius becomes double, then the mass raised, amount of liquid raised is also becoming doubled. So this way they'll ask the questions based on capillary tube. Let us take one final question related to the same concept. That is, what is that question? They have given two different liquids. One is mercury and another one is water. And they have given the ratio of surface tension for mercury and water as 7.5. And they have given the density ratio as 13.6. And they have given the angle of contact, that is for mercury 135 and for water it is 0 degrees. Then mercury drop by height h, mercury reduces its height because the angle of contact is greater than 90, as I told you. And water rises by same height but in another tube of radius r2. Then find r1 by r2. H equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g. Now here one is mercury, another one is water. So density is not same, but g is same. 2 is a constant. Radius is different, but height is same for both of them. Then r is proportional to t cos theta by rho. Then they are asking r1 by r2. that means R for mercury by R for water. First R for mercury, T for mercury, cos theta for mercury by rho for mercury times T for water, cos theta for water by rho for water. This way. Now R1 by R2 will become Tm by Tw, how much? 7.5. And rho m by rho w, here rho w by rho m is there, so 1 by 13.6. And cos theta m, theta 135, cos 135, cos 90 plus 45, so minus sin 45. If you take the magnitude, that is 1 by root 2 by cos 0, 1. So if you calculate, then you will get the ratio. So this way you can understand and you can solve the questions. So don't worry that the question is big. Understand, write the data, take the corresponding appropriate suitable formula, then just try to substitute. It may be comparison type of question, it may be direct type of question. So this is how you can deal with the surface tension. So one of the easiest, but calculation is important. So hope you all understood how to deal with surface tension questions. So thank you so much. We will continue our next session.